Okay, ipakita ko sa inyo ang paglilaid ng kable ng tama. Yan. Nakalaid na siya, dire-derecho, papunta dun sa termination point niya. Okay. Nandito tayo ngayon sa cellar section ng substation. Ayan, termination point. Nakadress na siya, ready for plug-in. So, makikita kayo dito ngayon ng bending radius. So, ano ba requirement ng bending radius ng mga kable? Power cable, especially power cable. Punta muna tayo dun sa may sensor kasi etong sensor dito is a motion detector sensor. Once it did not detect any motion here, the lights will be off. That's why, okay, the sensor now is on top of us, so lights will not be off. So guys, we'll continue explaining what is the requirement of cable bending radius. So the requirement is 10 to 12 times its outside diameter. So whatever is the size of the cable, either single core, armor, non-armor, multi-core, always do this one. 10 to 12 times its outside diameter is the safest bending radius of the cable. The cable is not stressed and it will not be damaged. That is our common practice here. As you can see also in the document attached in the NEC, it clearly mentioned there 12 times its outside diameter. Okay? Thank you.